So for all of our system setup, for all of the pipe work, we're going to use swagelok connections. So we'll just go over how to make a swagelok connection, and this will be the same across both tube sizes and all different fittings. Just obviously the pipe length will be different depending on where you're connecting to. So for this, we'll just demo connecting onto the front of this pressure controller just here. So you'll need your pipe cutter, some appropriate length tubing, which we can obviously trim down to size, an 11 millimeter spanner or using one of the adjustable spanners provided, and then the swagelok fittings, either the spare ones that came out of the hydraulic kit, or some of the fittings are already located on the valves or connections that we use. So the first thing we'll do is we'll just remove this blanking nut off of the front of this pressure controller here. And we can keep those safe at any point or use those again if we need to. Taking some pipe for the first end, we can just swage that on and then we'll measure it to the right length. But to cut the pipe cutter has a blade on one side and a V-shape at the bottom. So we can slot the pipe into the V-shape and just drop the blade on top, and then placing our thumb over the top of the blade section, just gently push down, and that'll give us a nice, straight, clean cut. So now we've cut our pipe, we can pick up our swagelok connection. Put your finger over the end, stops all the internal fittings coming out. Push the pipe in, keeping the finger over the end until you feel the pipe push against your finger, and then slide down. So the reason for this, if we give it a little shake here, we'll see it's broken down into three components. The nut and ferrule set and the backing nut. So what I tend to do when placing it into the fittings, push it all the way in with the components quite a way back, and we can feel it hit right up against the back. So keeping pressure on there to keep it fitted all the way back, we'll slide all of the components as one, and then thread on until finger tight. At this point, this is a first initial connection, so we're going to want 3/4 of a turn. So we'll go a half, and then an additional quarter. We'll just back that off, and we can unwind it by hand. What we'll see now is these are fitted and securely connected at the front with a nice little bit of tube just sticking slightly out the front of the cone there. Once we've made a connection, at any point you can remove it, refit it, but always finger tight, and this time round, just enough on the spanner to tighten it up so you can't undo it by hand. We can do that for all of our tubes, all of the connections, so we'll probably use an 8 millimeter for the cell pressure here and connect that into the cell and all of the other connections that you may need.